there are many million bacteria growing in your dishwasher. That's one of them spinning around happily. And I'm first going to show you some of these bacteria under my microscope, and later I'll give you some tips on what you can do against them so that you can start to enjoy your meal again. Hi, Microbe Hunter here, and I think that this is here the most disgusting place in my whole apartment. And I'm gonna show you something. I gotta reach in here and I'm gonna take out the filter. And you will see that there is a lot of slime and a lot of grime and yucky stuff on here. We biologists call this a biofilm, and there are billions of bacteria growing in here. And what I wanna do is I wanna figure out now is why do they like to grow in here even though the dishwasher is such an inconvenient environment. Very high temperatures, aggressive chemicals are in here, but still the bacteria seem to love it here. I'll try to answer this question, and of course I'll be using my microscope.
Well, and while I prepare the microscope slide for observation, well, what's the answer now to my question of why are bacteria able to survive such extreme conditions? And the answer is most of them, as a matter of fact, don't. Indeed, the high temperature and the aggressive chemicals of the cleaning powder actually will kill off most of the bacteria, but the stronger ones, they survive and they continue to thrive inside the dishwasher. So when I finished washing the dishes, those bacteria that have survived are able to continue to grow again, and they start to reform and rebuild the biofilm. So essentially over the weeks and months and years, what we've done is we have grown and bred thermophilic bacteria. Thermophilic bacteria are heat-loving bacteria. So this is what we see here under the microscope, and even though it looks messy and chaotic, it's actually quite informative here. And we can see already many bacteria. These are the small moving dots that you see scattered about, and I can also see some fungi. These are the long structures that you see on the right side. There is also a big blob towards the central left. Now, I don't know what that is. This could be some coagulated food, a protein or whatever. And when we change the focus, we can see very nice round structures, and these are fat droplets, and these fat droplets can of course also serve as food for the bacteria.
I think the contrast is quite low. The bacteria are kind of difficult to see. They're quite small, they're transparent. And what I want to do now is I want to have a look at the specimen using phase contrast microscopy. So what I have to do now is I have to change microscopes.
And we see again a whole bunch of fat droplets, those nice round yellowish structures. They start to be now much more visible than before, and they stream downwards. And why is this happening? Why are they moving downwards? And the reason is that there is water evaporating from the slide, and this causes in general water flow. But we can also see now the bacteria between those fat droplets, and they appear to be like dark little dots that are also wiggling around. And yeah, that here is a fungus, and I know that because this of the string-like structure, and you can see that the cells here are significantly larger than those of the bacteria. Here you again see the string-like structures, and yeah, what does this show us? A dishwasher, that's almost like a complete ecosystem of life that you have here. Obviously, all of those little organisms, they like to be around in a nutrient rich area. Yeah, I zoomed in a little bit more right now, and now you can see some of the bacteria that are moving. Here, that's one that's moving around, wiggling around a little bit. Bacteria, some of them, they move because they have so-called flagella. And these flagella, these are long extensions that work like a propeller. And this one is now spinning around in a circle. And I think the flagellum got stuck now somewhere on the slide, and therefore it's spinning the whole cell around. It's exactly the opposite way as it should be. And if you also look very carefully, you can also see that the fat droplets, they too are moving, but that is because of so-called Brownian motion. That's the thermal activity of the water molecules cause the wigglings of the fat droplets.
Well, now it shouldn't come as a surprise to you that scientists already have started to investigate and study the bacteria found in the dishwasher. And of course, sooner or later, also the media picked up on that. And I have to admit, I think it's kind of funny how different newspapers respond to this. There are some newspapers with headlines that really try to scare you a lot. And then there are other newspapers who say, well, it's actually okay because these bacteria are part of our natural environment. Well, in any case, I'm just going to give you a few tips on how you can reduce the number of these bacteria so that you can sleep a little bit better. I don't think it's absolutely necessary, but I think it's still general hygienics. And one of the things that you should not do or it's not necessary to do, is if you think that you have to go into your dishwasher now with some kind of disinfectant or antibacterial stuff, then I would say, if it makes you feel better, but after a few days, the bacteria will have grown back. So I think it's much better to establish some kind of a general hygienic routine that you can use on a regular basis. And I think that's much more useful than trying to disinfect something which is only of a very limited use for very limited time period. So my first suggestion is the following: is before you actually put the plates into the dishwasher, why not simply rinse them off first? And this has several interesting effects. First of all, the enzymes that you can find in the dishwashing tabs or dishwashing powder, they basically are now able to be more effective because they simply have less material to work on, because they're enzymes in the dishwashing chemicals, and they basically break down the food. And at the same time, it's also like this, that this also reduces the amount of nutrients that collect in the dishwasher, and there are also the bacteria have less food, so to say, to eat. And the second suggestion that I have is every now and then, maybe once a week or something like that, maybe you can simply turn on your dishwasher without any dishes at all, because this will also clean all of the pipes of the dishwasher, and it will also drain the water, and this kind of flushes away many of the food particles that might have accumulated, and also some bacteria will of course go away this way. Next recommendation, why not take out all of those parts every now and then and simply give them a rinse with your shower and with some hot water. Biofilm will be removed this way, and this way you of course also remove many of the bacteria, and this way you also have less organic material in the dishwasher for bacteria to actually feed on. And I've also read in the newspaper, and they said is allow the dishwasher to cool down first before opening it, because when you open it when it's hot, then there's steam coming out, and with the steam it's possible also for certain bacteria to spread in the air of your kitchen. Well, these are some general basic suggestions. I have to admit, I'll be very honest with you, with the exception of simply rinsing the sieve every now and then, I have not really done any of the other things to keep my dishwasher clean in my apartment. And you know what? I'm still healthy and everything's still fine. So I would say, worry a little bit about general hygiene, but not too much, I would say. I think it's certainly not necessary to lose a sleepless night over the whole thing. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. Please subscribe to the channel if you liked it. Also have a look at some of the other links in the description below, and see you around next time. Bye-bye.